Welcome to the Science Kitchen, where we talk with researchers and experts in nutrition science, psychology, and wellness. I'm Min, and I'm here today with Carla Quenter. She's a PhD student in University of Helsinki, specialized in mechanical regulation of glucoside. She did her bachelor degree in the biotechnology with a group of tissue engineer in Germany, and she continued her master degree in biomedical science, specialized in cancer biology. And today she's here with me to talk about migration of immune cells and how it's related to stress.
Yes.
So what is your info about that?
Well, first of all, thank you very much for the introduction and for giving me the opportunity to talk about my project. So my project deals with the immune system, or basically the soldiers of the immune system, because the immune system is kind of the protective system of the body. So it works like an army. So it has like small soldiers scattered throughout your body, which are immune cells. And then it also has like control hubs in your body, which are like releasing new recruits, if you want to, from the bone marrow into the bloodstream, and then they go to get trained in like the fibers of the spleen, or then they get activated and targeted in the lymph nodes, which you recognize during when you're sick, because then it starts to hurt and it's warning maybe under your arm or here. And so the immune system has a huge job to do, because the body is quite big and immune cells are quite small. And so there's like the logistical challenge that if you, let's say, step on a nail and there's hepatitis virus on there, like how does the immune cells, which are like here, go to the site of infection and then battle the enemy, and like how do they even know that there's an infection? So you have scattered throughout your body already immune cells everywhere, and one of these cells are kind of like, they're called dendritic cells, and they function like scouts, if you want to. So they take up, they get activated and they take up proteins, and then they carry them and migrate, so move towards lymph nodes, where they meet these very special elite fighter cells, which are like T cells, and give them like a part of the pathogen or like bacteria or virus, and like here fight this, and then these cells start to proliferate or multiply, and the ones which are best in recognizing this pathogen, which are then selected, and then they go to the site of infection and fight there. And this all works by the immune system talking to each other, and they have like special signaling molecules. And these are called cytokines, so it's just like messages, special kinds of messages. And these kind of signaling molecules are also really important in stress, and have an important role there.
So how this kind of migration of the immune cell can relate it to the body, somebody, you know, when they're in stressful situation?
That's a good question. So stress is our response to perceived threat. So evolutionary, it was developed in order to switch the energy from like the digestive tract, where you get more energy out eventually and like sexual reproduction, to the other part where you have like a lot of energy in your muscles and your skeletal muscles in order to fight, flight, or freeze. And another part of this response, the stress response, is then that immune cells are released into the bloodstream, and then also these signaling molecules of the immune system are released. And the interesting part, which is now investigated a lot, is that these signaling molecules of the immune system also influence brain activity and neural activity. And that's very interesting, and like really, if we now take a very dramatic example of stress, for example, post-traumatic stress disorder, which is a disease in response to a huge traumatic level of stress. And there you have elevated levels of these signaling molecules, and this then, so you have a heightened inflammation, so a lot of immune cell activity. And this then leads to the brain being influenced and certain parts of the brain being affected. And for example, the amygdala, which is important for, I think, fear response.
Yes.
And then the hypothalamus, which is also influenced. And I think it has to do with memory. So that's like post-traumatic stress disorder, that you have these flashbacks of memories, or like memories are being repressed. Mm. So that comes from this effect of the cytokines, the immune cell signaling. And what happens in these areas of the brain is that the metabolism has changed, so how the cells take up nutrients and process them is changed, and then also cell death happens, and neurons can't divide anymore, so not only is your brain getting damaged, also it can't repair itself anymore so well, so that's like pretty huge. And as a consequence of this, then maybe your behavior has changed, and also this one area in the brain where you're like alert and it regulates your motor control is changed, so you might be very, I don't know, might be very alert and
maybe anxious.
Yes, like anxiety and depression are really also linked to inflammation, and there's one also learning, interestingly, that so there's this hypothesis that this theory that the signaling molecule of the immune system, IL-1 beta, it is in very small amounts in the brain and is needed in order for learning to occur. But when there's a full-blown immune response going on, then this amount is increased so drastically that learning is no longer possible.
Okay.
So, and then there are some researchers who think that this disease response, which is a consequence of this huge amount of IL-1 beta, is actually also seen in depression, where you like withdraw from society and you get really lethargic because the body wants to shift the energy from doing outwardly stuff to more like, you know, heal and be quiet and let the body deal with it. Yeah. So, yeah. So
because of all the stress.
I think it's really difficult to nail down what is like the cause. Post-traumatic stress disorder is maybe an exception, but like depression, it's difficult to pinpoint what's now the cause, why does it erupt and stuff, but it certainly influences each other, and quite often in psychotic, like, sorry for the word, like diseases like depression and anxiety, they quite often, you don't just have one, you have several, and the symptoms are overlapping, so it's really, really difficult to pinpoint one.
Especially, psychological disorder can be caused by many things in your body.
And
all of those, maybe in the end, can influence your immune system.
Absolutely.
Like how the immune system regulate, you know, the chemical in your body, so it can actually heal yourself from the inside.
Yes, but I guess the kind of sad thing is that everything is quite messy, and it influences each other, and it's quite often there's like a downward spiral. For example, in post-traumatic stress disorder, you have more stress, and then this leads to you being more sensitive to stress. So it's easier for you to get stressed, and then this whole pathway gets more reinforced, and it's like you get primed to be like this.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, research has now also shown in neuroscience that your brain can also learn to undo these pathways.
Mm.
So like it's really very plastic, which means changeable.
Yeah, the plasticity of the brain.
Yes. So, but it's, I think the bottom line is that avoid stress and like relax and give your body time to heal and eat good food. And
Eat good food.
Yeah, of course, because all the body, the nutrients are like the future bricks of where everything in your body is built on, and also like an immune response. These cells produce each other very fast and generate huge amounts of new cells. So all of this is a lot of effort and costs a lot of raw material. So you need to get good quality stuff into your body.
And well, being relaxed is also one of the quality time that can help your immune system to work properly.
But
sometimes acute stress is good for it's good for your immune system, not like chronic stress we talked about.
Yeah, I think like it definitely has a place in biology, and it helped the human species to survive, no doubt about this. It's just that now we are maybe not faced with the same threats anymore. Like there's no saber-tooth tiger around trying to eat you, and then you run away, and then the stress ends because you escaped.
Yeah.
Or you died, and then obviously it's over. But today, like, the stress is more like your boss or your girlfriend, and then it's maybe not the best idea to punch them in the face and like release the stress through like physical exertion. So it's better to do sports and get it out of your system like this. And
Or maybe even get stressed about what to eat, but that's another topic. But right now, mentioning about food, we have another friend in the kitchen right now preparing good food for us. So let's move to the kitchen and see what they have for us. Hello, Rosie.
Hi. Well, speaking about good food.
So she's also one of my friends, and she's going to make Asian food today. And so I can see all from the ingredients.
Honestly, I would say it's not really Asian. It's just my thing, you know. Just a random mix. So she had just mentioned about good food. Well, for me, honestly, I don't really understand everything she said. It's way far too smart for me. Anyway, but let's speak about normal people then.
Okay.
We want good food, but nowadays it's very important also that we need to have good nutrition, as you say. And there's a trend now that you should eat clean.
Yeah.
Fresh and clean.
Okay.
It's very important. And from my experience, I was really depressed a few months ago. Really. First of all, Finnish weather.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's too dark. And there was a lot of stress that I had to handle too, because I have my own business, and it's not always easy. So when you're stressed, you tend to eat a lot of not good food, like unhealthy. We love stuff, a lot of sugar,
calorie rich food,
like a bomb of calories.
Yes,
but then when spring comes, you feel like, okay, I cannot live your life like this anymore. So I just made a change, first of all, with my food, with my diet, and eating.
Of course.
And I recognize a huge difference. Once you start to care about what you eat, what you intake in your body, it immediately create a positive impact. Like you feel better, you're always in good mood.
Yeah.
And of course, another thing, your body will be better.
Well, and actually your immune system is something can be changed and work like better too, but you can't actually see it.
Yeah, well, I believe you, because I haven't been sick for quite a long time. Of course. So yes, back to the food. So today we make a kind of salad, let's say. It's Asian salad. With me, salads, technically, you just put everything you want.
Yeah.
In a bowl. Make a good sauce with it, and that's it.
I like that.
Really simple.
Nice. Very simple. Yes, exactly. But always you need carb, protein, and vegetable.
Okay.
And good sauce, always.
Yeah, good sauce. That's the thing.
Yes. This actually being influenced like by a restaurant in USA. I don't remember the name, but I saw that on Facebook, and they make this kind of salad with peanut butter sauce.
Cool.
And I feel like, okay, that is a very good one, and it's very fresh, and it might be good for my body. So
okay. So let's do it then.
Yes, so technically it's very simple. you know rice noodle?
Yeah. This is
yes.
Rice vermicelli.
Vermicelli, exactly, yeah. So we just boiled it, and any kind of vegetable you would like to have, fresh, preferable fresh. And then some protein, I choose to have tofu, and you also can add cashew and any kind of nut that you would like to have in. And the most important thing of this salad is the sauce. So technically this is sauce, it doesn't look really nice at the moment. It tastes good.
Well, actually, it might not look nice to somebody, but clearly, guys, standing here, the peanut butter smell and the soy sauce and everything from it just smell amazing.
Yeah. Well, with the sauce, with Asian kind of sauce, it's very simple. You have to have something salty. In this case, we use soya. You can also use fish sauce, but let's keep it vegetarian. Yes. And then you need something sour, like lemon or vinegar. This time I choose the rice vinegar.
Okay.
And then some sugar. Preferable, the less the possible. The less the possible. No,
yeah.
The better.
Yes.
Yeah, and then peanut butter for the special sauce. And so it's very simple. You just put everything in a bowl, mix it up, and
enjoy
it. Yes.
Okay.
So let's start with this. Oh, it's still hot.
Oh, nice.
So is this a warm salad?
No, it's not supposed to be, but since we don't have a lot of time, so it is not cooled down completely yet. So if you make it at home, prefer to make it cool.
So, yeah, okay.
Soak it in cold water.
Well, and actually now
okay.
The weather outside of Finland is quite hot, so I think this combination would be, you know, really refreshing for somebody, you know?
Yeah. Well, at least the vegetable is cold, so it's gonna be fine. So let's start with some bell pepper. Nice color, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's the
by the way, have you ever tried this recipe before?
I used that in my coffee shop before. It's like one
okay.
option for vegan, because when you once you do business in Finland, you just realize, oh, okay, there's a lot of demand in food.
Okay.
Well, yeah, like
that's gonna be another topic. Gluten-free,
lactose-free, vegan, vegetarian, special diet, and allergies so much.
Okay.
But yeah, I used this before and it's pretty good.
Okay.
Some.
How do you feel when you eat it? Like refreshing?
Refreshing, like completely refreshing. Like you feel good. You just feel good when you eat it. Like, as I told you, when you eat too much of sugar and too much of unhealthy food, your body is, it's just so heavy in a way.
Yeah.
It's not like when you stand on the scale or whatever, but you just feel very heavy. You don't feel like you have energy to do anything. You just want to lie on the couch and be lazy, and that's bad.
That's
we don't want that.
It's bad for the immune system too.
Well, especially
I guess so, but it's also like I always feel like, oh, what have I done again? The inner focus one.
Well, you know, from time to time, some Snickers doesn't help.
Or ice cream.
Yeah. Well, there's one time I just take the whole pack of Snickers lying on my bed and just open everything and eat.
Okay, that is depressing. Oh, wait, maybe we can edit this part out when we're talking about Snickers and ice cream. We're making healthy food, but still, like, I don't know how, but these, like, sugary food can sneak into the coffee too.
Yeah.
Well,
you cannot cut them down completely, but
moderate
portions.
Yeah.
It's good. So, yeah, everything is in here.
Okay,
and now
the sauce.
The sauce in.
Are you going to mix it with your hand?
Well, if I'm at home, I'm not going to do it. But since we're live stream, we're going to try to be like more hygiene, I guess. So we just mix everything. Normally, I do it with chopstick. It's easier with Asian people.
Mm.
But seeing we don't have chopstick, I'll just let's try.
I would imagine it's a bigger, like way bigger chopsticks.
I'm more flexible.
Do you need more sauce?
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Do we have like bowls for the portions?
What?
Do we have like smaller bowls for the portions?
Yes, totally. All of you are going to try it in the end. But yeah, this is like perfect for summer. During summer, you don't need like oily and heavy food. Just this with a lot of vegetable. I love it.
Yeah, and the colors make you really happy.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's okay.
You have like green there, you have red there, you have yellow there.
Yeah, I love the yellow.
And white too.
Just
really balancing colorations and the brown from sauce also.
Sorry.
What? Oh, come on.
But anyway, technically you can put anything you want inside. this time I forgot, but if you can put some basilica or mint, it's
gonna
be
nice.
Awesome.
Oh, fresh herbs, yeah.
Fresh herb is awesome. I love it. Like every time I go to the supermarket, I just like sniffing all of the basilica. Yeah, it's also nice.
Oh, let's imagine her. I imagine her like standing in the supermarket just sniffing the herbs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's like a creep. Like, seriously, I look like a creep. Yes, so technically that's it.
Yeah.
Of course, if you want to make it look more fancy, you can put some green salad around it and some cashew or fried onion on top.
Oh, nice.
But I keep it simple.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it. Yeah.
Or you can add whatever herb you like.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
It's really subjective.
Yes.
Cashew.
So, let's try. Oh, wanna be there.
I wanna guinea pig.
Yeah.
I wanna be the lab rat.
Come on. Okay, try it. You are the
two.
Yeah. So yeah, honestly, before I go to Europe, never eat salad. I hate it.
I don't like salad
much. No, the thing is, in Vietnamese cuisine, there's a lot of vegetable already, so you don't feel the need of having a special salad dish. But since I moved here and I try it, it's actually really good.
Well, it's not fair.
Come on,
you
have
more.
You can have more.
Okay,
later.
Let's try it.
Just try it.
Oh, it's amazing. I love the sauce.
Oh, yeah.
Is it, right?
It's really balanced in taste, in texture and everything.
Hmm. Are you doing that because we are family or is this really
No, really, it's really balanced. Oh my god, come on.
No. I know. I made it so. But yeah,
I know.
Exactly.
It's really balanced.
But yeah. So if you try it at home, just do whatever. Put any kind of vegetable you would like to have in your salad, and you just need a good sauce. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's summer anyway. So yeah.
Nice.
So yeah.
It's really good. It is really good.
Mm.
And it can be done only like 15 minutes,
yeah.
5 minutes.
Yeah, it's very quick. The main thing you have to do is like just cut the vegetable and that's it.
Well, you can have a machine to do that for you nowadays.
Well, the part of the machine doing it, but after you have to clean the machine, it's like equally.
Okay. So, like cutting the vegetable is a kind of like meditation for some people.
Yeah, actually it is. Like sometime when you're at work and your boss is so mean to you and you're like, oh my god, I want to punch him. Like,
yeah.
You have that, right?
Just
go home and chop the vegetable.
Excellent.
Straight release.
Put all of your adrenaline on the vegetable. Just don't do that.
Okay, yeah. So
but it's really nice.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I'm glad that you enjoy it.
Yeah, and the ingredients are like really humble, really cheap too.
Well, food is not about expensive ingredients. Okay, of course, expensive ingredients normally taste really good, but if you don't know how to cook it, then
yeah, it's still,
But if you know how to make things, then you can do good things out of very simple things.
Yeah, like this is really simple, but it's really tasty.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
It's really good. So, and yet, thank you for this wonderful, summer salad.
Yes, summer salad.
Thank you very much.
Summer salad with the peanut butter sauce. Thank you.
The sauce has peanut butter, soya, some sugar, the less the better, and vinegar. So that's it. You have a perfect combination.
Oh, yeah. And well, thank you for coming to the show today.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, with really interesting information about how your immune cells, migrate from their camp to where you get the injury or the stress or the having a pathogen, invading your body and bring it back to the central headquarters, and all the soldier means your immune cells, go to that injury and heal the wound. And it actually related to your stress too, and it's just really good information. It's really thank you.
Thank you.
And I would like to also thank you for more people behind the camera.
Yes.
Carlos.
Yay.
Leah from the science basement and Anjana, she's the venue owner.
Thank you.
Bye, see you next time.
See you.